morning, everyone. Thank you for having me. I'm glad to be here to introduce you today with Elsight, for those of you who didn't hear about us. Elsight is in the highly reliable communication business, and it's kind of being in the perfect storm today, because if we're thinking about what is connected today, we're all connected. I guess if I'll ask here the audience who doesn't have cell phone in his pocket, probably the answer will be zero and no one will raise hands. And everything is connected today, from our cell phones to our cars. Even I saw the other day a toothbrush that is connected, believe it or not, but 5G toothbrush. I have no idea what is the purpose of it, but it is existing. Anyway, so this is what we're doing. We are in the highly reliable communication world. And even more exciting, we chose to focus our business strategically on the unmanned industry, which include drones, ground vehicles, a maritime vehicle sometimes. And I would like to introduce you with how excited it is to be in this middle of this perfect storm and try to share with you some of this excitement in the next couple of minutes. So starting with the numbers, what we saw in the last year, if you compare 2023 to 2024, financial or calendar years, that we saw almost doubled in the revenue in the first half of the year. We're seeing the same trend continue. So when I'm saying that we're in the middle of the perfect storm, I mean that we are right on the start of this hockey stick, start to growing our revenue pretty dramatically, like I said, almost doubling it, and not only the revenue, but from different sectors, make it more diverse. Part of our business model is the recurrent revenue, which taking a bigger and bigger part of our overall revenue, which is also good news looking forward and how we create sustainable business. So overall, the numbers, I think, represent where we at in terms of this storm that I just mentioned, or where we at in our journey. A little bit about Elsight. So starting from the technology, and I'll try to explain the technology very briefly in two slides, but just to understand that all the technology is proprietary Elsight technology. Everything is developed and was developed in-house, including all the patents, all the engineering that was put into it. And the reason I'm mentioning it is because that's provide us the capability or the freedom to adapt our system to the customer's needs, or the industry trends, or whatever we see in front of us. And that's basically what we do, understanding what are the needs coming from the customers and industries. I'll talk about it in a second, and how we translate it into more feature, which translate to more revenue on the other side, obviously. So that's one. The second one, looking on markets, or the reason we chose to go to the unmanned market, we were looking for a market that have a must-have need for critical communication, like I mentioned before. And unlike other markets, for us, the uncrewed market was a market that represents where you must have communication. As an operator or as a command center or whatever it is, you must have reliable communication between the operators and the platforms to be able to monitor and control them regardless of what is the mission or what is the use case that they are doing. So that's one hand. On the other hand, we found that in this market, it was very hard to say this is the market leader or who is the market leader. And I'm going to sound a little arrogant, but we thought, and we're still thinking, I'll show you how we are getting there. We thought that Elsight can become this industry leader or industry standard, and that was about 3 years ago when we launched our product. And since then, we're achieving milestone after the other. I'll show you in the next slide about timeline, how we're putting ourselves as industry standard. And just to give you some names to mention, as part of our customers, not as a proof of concept, not as the trials, but as actual customers that paying both the one-time revenue and the recurrent revenue. So today, we have under our belt Walmart, which is the largest retailer in the world, doing their drone deliveries. I'll talk about it later in the presentation. We have the largest defense contractor, Lockheed Martin, that just announced 3 months ago that they're starting to sell their drones based on our technology, on our systems. We were the first one, one of our partners were the first one to get the FAA type certificate, which is very big news to the industry, not only for our customers and for us, but for the entire industry, that those drones can travel around to do last mile logistics, to do healthcare services, to do inspections and different type of applications and use cases that are being used and done much more efficiently and much more productively using uncrewed system, whether it's in the air or in the ground or overseas. So in terms of product validation, understanding that you are doing something right, I think that we are right there, having all those customers' leads and all those giants that you can assume they're doing a lot of due diligence on the technology, taking it to the edge, trying to challenge it, trying to fail it. And once we understand that we are the default for Lockheed Martin for their drones, for example, that represents that we're doing something good and something right. And that's what I mentioned, why we're only at the beginning of where we're at. Speaking of growth engines, so not only in the industry, I'll talk about adjacent industries that we can go to, but in our industry, we have multiple growth engines. The obvious ones are growing our customers base, which grew pretty nicely in the last 2 years. I'll share it. The second one is how we increase what we call in the SaaS world, in the software as a service world, ARPU, average revenue per unit or per user. How we provide more features, more capabilities basically to our customers based on their needs or their challenges, whether they know they have a challenge or not, and by that creating more value for them, and for us creating more value by generating more recurrent revenue as a vehicle. So that's the second one. The third one is going into new territories, new use cases that we haven't touched before. And the fourth one, which is probably the biggest for us, is to go into other markets. Like I mentioned before, critical communication today, you can think if we will do a poll here, we will probably get as many opinion as the number of people in the room of what you can do with critical communication, from homeland security to healthcare services, like I mentioned before, and the list goes on and on. But we think, or my own belief as the CEO of the company, I think that companies, for sure small companies, need to be laser focused. Once we feel that we're dominating the market, that will be the right time, or once we feel that the market is too small for us, that will be the right time for us to go to the next market and to iterate on that for either adjacent market, like you see here, which are all of them are much larger markets, or completely parallel markets, which are not related at all to what we're doing today, but have the needs for, like I said, for this critical communication need. Just to share with you a little bit about our journey, I mentioned part of it, but the company have started before that, but we launched our new product to this specific industry, to the uncrewed industry. We launched our product in the beginning of 2021. The product name is Halo. You'll see it in two slides. And since then, we accumulated or we gained a very good traction throughout the years until a year ago, and I'll talk about the split a year ago. But before that, like I said, onboarding a lot of customers, mainly in the commercial market for last middle mile logistics with drones, actual deliveries, inspections. Again, different type of industries that are enjoying the efficiency of those systems. So companies like Walmart that I mentioned before, or Sprite in the US, or Speedbird in Brazil, or throughout the world, Sphere drones here in Australia, and the list goes on and on. Again, a lot of companies, some of them are small, some of them are big, but we had very good progress. In May 2022, we signed a deal with DroneUp Walmart. That's the Walmart company who are doing their drone deliveries, basically. We'll talk about that. In September of last year, one of our partners secured the first FAA type certificate that I mentioned before, which was a very big deal for the industry. That was the first one, and by now it's the only one still, which is a very long process, taking the technology or the whole system to the edge, trying to find the edge cases of how to fail it, so we all can be sure that if we're getting our delivery with drone, and it sounds futuristic, but I'll show you how much is not futuristic, it's currently happening, it will be safe, it will be secure, we won't have any privacy issue with that. So those are all the tests that the regulatory authorities are doing, and we were the first one with our customers to go through this process. In last year, what happens to us is that we figure out, or we were pulled into the homeland security and defense market for different reasons, starting with big contract, we doubled our revenue, and since then we're seeing a great traction within this market. And now when we're looking on both market, on one hand the commercial market, on the other side the defense market, this is one of our growth engines. Now to give you something that I consider good news as the way we see it. If we're looking on the short, medium term, we believe that the defense market will be bigger because everyone are seeing what's happened around us. Oleg just talked about it this morning of the use of drone for different applications, but how those systems, how those platforms can do good for the world, and this is what we are enabling. how we will get our deliveries faster, how we'll make our cities safer, how we'll take the carbon footprint down by using less vehicle for deliveries or for other purposes, whether it's inspection or whatever. So this is what we're seeing that will, in the middle long term, this is what will grow into be a much more meaningful market, not only for us, but the entire drone or uncrewed industry ecosystem as a whole, which is, this is why it's so interesting to be as part of it. It is unfortunate circumstances what we're seeing around us in the world today, but still we're trying to make the most of it, seeing what is our opportunity in the defense market, and we're seeing that we have very strong one. Like I mentioned, Lockheed Martin a few minutes ago, same for that. We have a lot of deployments both in the Middle East, in the Ukraine-Russia conflict, that are using our systems for different purposes, for homeland security and public safety. We have a lot of usage, and we're seeing a lot happening there. And I'm glad to be here on the stage today because we literally, about an hour ago, just announced our a very big contract that we just signed that will more than double our revenue if everything will go as planned in the next 1-2 years. And that is a very meaningful, very strong announcement that we've made just an hour ago. And like I mentioned before, being in this beginning of this hockey stick, and we are right there of getting to big numbers. So I spoke about a lot about the ecosystem, where we at, where the markets are in our sector, but now I want to talk a little bit about what we're selling, what is Elsight about, and what we're actually doing. So like I said before, we are combining hardware and software. The hardware is a small piece that sits on the drone. It's actually, I think I have one right here on my pocket. That's the kind of the brain that sits on the drone, all connected to our Elsight cloud to enable this all communication between the two sides. I'll play a 2-minute video to explain it much better than I'll do, and I'll continue with the presentation.
The drone market is expanding as industries develop use cases to take advantage of drones' flexibility, mission agility, and cost benefits. But maintaining communication between drone and operator is an enormous challenge, especially over long distances. In fact, it's virtually impossible to control drones beyond the visual line of sight. RF is limited in range and reliability, satellite communication is costly and limited in bandwidth, and using just one SIM card lacks the redundancy and coverage required for safe BVLOS operations. That's why we created Halo, our next generation communication platform, providing superior always-on connectivity and solving the BVLOS challenge once and for all. Halo bonds multiple communication links from different carriers, combining ultra-low latency with high bandwidth, enabling seamless transmission of data. The sixth sense algorithm encrypts the data, splits the data into packets, prioritizes, and transmits it through a secure network tunnel. Halo automatically detects failed communication channels, instantly transmitting the data on an alternate link without the disconnect caused by traditional failover. Halo aggregates 4G, LTE, 5G, local RF, satellite communications, and mesh to provide the ultimate connectivity solution. With BVLOS architecture tailored to unmanned operations, Halo enables simultaneous operation of numerous drones from the same control center using Elsight's cloud management platform. Additional flight related features include mapping and route planning, native Mavlink support, and ASTM compliant broadcast and network remote ID capabilities. Join the dozens of global partners already using Halo to propel their BVLOS operations forward. Elsight, a new era of connectivity.
So this is a technology, and someone might think that every new sector, any new customer that we have, we need to do this customization for this specific customer. But the good news is kind of one size fits all. So if I'm taking everything from Walmart on one hand and Lockheed Martin on the other hand, they're all using the same technology from our standpoint. They have their own configuration, obviously, which they do themselves. But for us, from research and development purpose standpoint, we're not affected by having more customers because it doesn't require more development on our side. We do a lot of development of what we think is the customer challenge and what will be in the future customer's challenges and how we optimize our revenue. That just as an example. I'll skip a few slides, be cautious for the time. Sorry. One slide back. So just about our customer base, you can see now that it's global. Like I said before, we had a great traction onboarding a lot of new customers, what we call design wins, meaning that those are paying customers, not trials or proof of concept. Those are customers that are actually using our systems either on a daily basis or more oftenly sometimes. Just to give you some examples of those names, I want to focus on the Drawn Up Walmart one, which I mentioned before. I said that I'm going to get back to it. So people might think that drone deliveries are extremely futuristic, but actually it's actually happened. Walmart today are serving more than 4 million households in the US. You can log into the Walmart mobile app, put whatever you want to put in your cart up to £5, and you'll get it in your backyard in 20 minutes. By the way, it will cost you $3.99. So it's really happening. It's not something that it's futuristic or anything like that. It's literally changing consumers' habits today and how we get our deliveries, how we get our convenience, and so on. Real quick on the revenue model, we have three main elements. One is the hardware sale, the unit that I just shared with you before. The other one is what we call Elsight Cloud, which is an inherent part of the product. It's not a nice to have. If you have only the hardware without a connection to the cloud, you have a piece of nothing, basically. And you see that in both sides, both on the hardware and on the cloud, we have a very healthy gross margins, which on the software we're expecting, on the SaaS, sorry, we're expecting the gross margin to grow as we move along because the costs remain the same and we are onboarding more customers to that. And the last element is actually, again, what I mentioned before, seeing customers' challenges and translate it into revenue. This is part of what we've done in the airtime, selling the actual SIM cards. So we found that it's hard to our customers to get it. We sell it for them, and now they have a one package, one-stop shop, and that creates a very interesting revenue for us, which drove our growth, like I mentioned in the beginning. Looking into the future, where we're at the moment, so we're seeing how we continue our deep market penetration or deep market leadership in the commercial market, while we're also penetrating the new defense and homeland security market and how we grow the revenue from there. And I'll stop here for a few questions. Thank you.
Let's say thank you. Yeah, thank you so much. Great story there. I've got a number of questions. We've not got a lot of time, but the good news is you have an exhibition stand.
Yeah, outside, I do. I'm here.
And you'll be around at morning tea. How does the drone and counter-drone market track one another in terms of evolution of products?
Good question. Like any other industries, when we have, on one hand, we have those that are protecting, and the other side, we have those that are enabling, I'll call it, or maybe it's not the right terms, but we see both industries are moving around or moving pretty fast forward, and I think we all hear about it all over the news, how counter-drones are working, like Oleg just mentioned, on the other hand, how drones are in use. But if there is one thing I wanted to get out of here, and that's my optimism maybe, is that I think that in 3-5 years' time, we'll see drones using for the good and how it's makes our life better, and not only for homeland security and defense purposes.
Sounds like you've got a couple of customers here. Do customers purchase the SIM from Elsight, or do they have to approach their service provider?
Yeah, so as I just mentioned, in our business model is part of our business model today, selling as a one-stop shop, so having on one side the hardware and the cloud to be connected to this hardware, but we found that it's a very, very big challenge, sorry, for our customers to bring the actual SIM cards, the airtime from the Optus and Telstra of the world. And today it's part of a built-in part of our model of selling also the airtime, by the way, not only from cellular, also the satellite airtime and other type of technologies that we are as part of our solution.
One or two around here about AI. What's the AI assurance in your company? How do you measure, what measures do you have in place to protect, and what are you considering in the future?
That's a question that you must ask in today's world. So AI, it's very broad definition, I would say. In our case, making the decision of which channel to use of all those available channels, like you saw in the video, the communication channel, that cannot take some simple algorithm that will do this load balancing or the split of the data. So this is basically our heritage, the algorithm that how to use or how to utilize the best way those type of infrastructure. That's where the AI or our algorithm or our IP sits. So that's where it is. In terms of safety, this part of the AI is part that is pretty easy to control, so we're not afraid that it will go anywhere that we're not expecting it to go because of the nature of the product and the technology.
Great, thank you. Look at that, zero, down, countdown, zero. We're right on time. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Let's say thank you to the AI again. Thanks.